Hello everyone, welcome back to Portal 7. In this video I will show you that how to merge or combine two ISO files for installing Windows 10 or 11. You can make one bootable USB drive for installing Windows 10 and 11. First of all, you should download ISO files of Windows 11 and Windows 10 from Microsoft's website. We will use two commands throughout this video. The commands will be found in the description of the video. Now we have to extract install.esd file from Windows 10 ISO file. You can use WinRAR or 7-zip to extract install.esd. But I will use other method which does not require any installation in Windows. Right-click on ISO file and click on Mount. Now open Sources folder and find install.esd. Now copy this file and paste in this folder. Same thing we will do with Windows 11 ISO file. But here we have to take install.wim file. Now open command prompt with administrative privileges. And copy the first command. The first command will tell you about the install.esd file and the install.wim file. You must replace the path to your files before executing the command. As you can see, the Windows 10 installer has 7 versions from index 1 to index 7. Now let's check Windows 11, for that use same command. But just change the install.esd to install.wim. As you can see, Windows 11 has 11 versions from index 1 to index 11. You need to pay attention to the index of Windows 10 installed versions, because the second command will need it. Let's move on to the main part of this video, which is adding Windows 10 installation versions to the Windows 11 installer. We will add versions of Windows 10 to the Windows 11 installer one by one. Now copy the second command and paste it. In this command you have to change 3 things. First, source path. Second, source index. And third, destination path. Set source path to install.esd, set index to 1. And set destination path to install.wim. Now execute the command. Executing will take some time. This will add the Windows 10 Home Installer to the install.wim file. So the command is completed. Now let's check the install.wim file information by using first command. As you can see, a 12th index has appeared, and that is the Windows 10 Home Installer. The install.wim file size has increased significantly more than 8 GB. Now let's add other Windows 10 installation versions too. In the install.wim file, for that, copy the second command and just change the index number. And repeat this process 6 more times for 7 versions of Windows 10. So now all 7 versions have been added to install.wim file. Now let's check the install.wim file information. As you can see now, there are all 18 versions of Windows installation. Windows 10 installer versions are indexed from 12 to 18. The size of the install.wim file is about more than 8 GB. Now we will create the Windows ISO file with this install.wim file. For that, I recommend you to use Anyburn software, which is a free utility. To create an ISO file that can be installed on a computer with hardware that does not support Windows 11, it is recommended to use the ISO file of the Windows 10 operating system. In Anyburn software, choose Edit Image File. Select Windows 10 image file and double-click Open Source folder. Find install.esd and remove it. Now click on Add and select the install.wim file, which we just created, and its size is more than 8 GB. Now click Next. You can rename the image file name and click on Create Now. It will take few minutes to create ISO file. So we have a new image file which have Windows 10 and Windows 11 both versions. Its size is more than 9 GB. So you will need a USB stick of at least 16 GB in size for the Windows installer. We will use Rufus to make a bootable Windows installer drive. Plug in a USB drive and click on Boot Selection. Choose newly created ISO file. Key partition scheme GPT. Click on Start. It will take few minutes to make a bootable drive. Now our 2-in-1 Windows installer is ready. We can use this USB stick to install Windows 10 and Windows 11.
To see more videos like this, please consider subscribing.